Hello everyone and welcome back to the Ranch of Rivershine. It is now day 10 of spring. Oh, we have a new quest, yay! Town statue. Greetings, Misty. I feel a bit silly writing to you about this, but I've noticed something strange with Wildsprout statue. It's probably nothing, but would you mind taking a look at it? It'll reassure me to have someone else to share this with, Madeline. Okay? And that looks like the only quest we have today. I'm gonna grab this straw, and I'm gonna quickly hide this quest. All right. And I'll just come check on my crops. Is anything ready to harvest? Maybe the carrots? How long till this is ready? Timothy, hey, we'll be ready tomorrow. Do I have any fertilizer for this? I don't, I must have used all my fertilizer. Okay. Oh, my carrots are ready to gather and I'm not gonna be putting, ooh, I got some a shield fertilizer. I think that's because I used the lucky fertilizer, so I got some shield fertilizer. How long till this is ready? 4 days. Wheat in 7 days. 2 days. And 4 days. I'm going to... Do I have any more wheat seeds? I do. I'm going to plant more wheat instead of carrots because wheat is the highest... it's the most profitable to plant. I don't have any... Oh, shield fertilizer. What does this do? Robust fertilizer protects your crop against harsh temperatures, allowing to grow all year long. Don't need that right now, but I think that's something I can use in like winter. But not needing it right this second. Okay. I also wanted to test something because I thought that horses lost energy just when you were riding them, but I have heard that they only lose energy when they're being trained. So I'm actually gonna take Obsidian out with me to Madeline, and we'll see if he loses energy even though he's not being trained. Hi, Obsidian. Let's give you a brush first. Okay. And you can have one of the carrots. Oh, look at him in his fancy gear. All right, let's mount up. All right, so I can see where his energy levels are right now. Let's see if he still loses energy. So that's his stamina going down, but will he still lose energy if he's not being trained? It's a little experiment. All right, come on. It means I'll be able to get this quest done quicker because I can gallop around on him. I think I'm going to take Divinity to do some competitions today. Okay, has his energy gone down? Hey, Madeline. No, it didn't go down at all. Oh, okay, that's interesting. I just thought the horses lost energy when you were riding them full stop. I kind of wish they did, but at the same time, it's kind of nice that they'll only lose energy when training or competing. That's handy, so I don't have to... I could just, like, ride Obsidian around everywhere and not have to worry about energy loss. Okay, Madeline. How's Obsidian faring? Still quest. I'm Misty. I've been wanting to talk to you about something strange. Have you noticed that every time you... win a competition in town, the glow of the statue, town statue gets stronger? I noticed the glow last time, I didn't know it was related to competitions. It was barely noticeable at first, but I've noticed it shining brighter and brighter. I know it sounds silly, but you wouldn't mind entertaining me. Keep winning competitions in town and let's see just how bright our statue can shine. Okay, chat. It's worth remembering that foals cannot be sold until they're fully grown. I can't personally allow separating horses at such a young age. At the very least, I'm sure it will be enjoyable to have them around your ranch until they're older. Okay, and... nothing else. Is there anything I can do with the statue? Faint glow. Okay. Win competitions in Rivershine's town to increase the statue's glow. Alright. Should I do some competitions now? I guess I will. Since I've got obsidian here, I kind of wish I'd given him an apple instead of a carrot. Oops. I'm gonna do some competitions and see if that increases the glow. To finish training Divinity and do some competitions on her too. Okay, let's go. And then I might be able to sell her this today, or I might have to wait till next time to sell her. I guess I'll see how we go. I need her to win at both of the competitions, and that will increase her price. So the price increases with not every competition, but every ribbon. So like if I have first place in this race and first place in another race, that will increase her value twice. But if I keep getting first place in the same race, it's not going to make a difference. Apparently, that's what I've heard. So, yeah. All right, come on. Get us some more money. I really hope I unlock some more horse colors soon. Okay, there we go. And has the glow increased? How's the glow looking? Can I check it while on obsidian? Don't think I can. A faint glow. Okay, it's still just a faint glow. What happens if we win the other race? Oh, I wish we had a treat to give obsidian. Oops. Okay. Let's do the Lupine Meadow race. Here we go. And then I'll go back to the ranch after this and bring Divinity out. Ooh, some oats. And hopefully today we'll finish her training. And competitions, and then we can sell her, I reckon. Come on. Oh no! I let the meter run out. Well, I guess I can get some cute pictures while that happens. Okay. Gotta be careful about the meter not running out. The stamina, I mean. Alright. Come on. Hopefully we'll unlock some more races soon, because currently I just have these two. And I wouldn't mind having a few new ones. I think I might also come into the Lupine Meadow to get some more of the Lucky Fertilizer, because that's really fun. I really like the Lucky Fertilizer and seeing like the different things we can get from it. All right, nearly there, obsidian. Go. Okay, gotta go back to a counter. And we finish. Oh, look! The other villagers are waiting for me at the finish line. I've never noticed that. What? We came third? Oh. Okay. It's probably because I trot. Oh, and also because I didn't have much energy. Well, let's see what kind of horses are behind the auction house today, because they do change. Okay, we've got a bay. I think that's a bay. Is that a dark chestnut? Not sure, because the bays do have brown manes and tails instead of black right now. Oh, this is a new one. It's a little brown pinto. Oh, this one's pretty. And then we have a dun. Oh, it's like a snowflake dun. Oh my gosh, I want it. I want either a snowflake dun or a snowflake buckskin. Okay, let's just oops. Let's just, no, come on. There we go. Teleport back to the entrance and I'll go grab Divinity now. And I think she's got 11% potential left. I think. Let's grab this. What? Yes, there is. There is space. Come on, let me down. Let me down. There we go. Oh, I know obsidian. Come on. Come on. There we go. You can go back in the paddock. And I'll give you a quick brush. You did a good job competing. There we go. Whoops, sorry. All right, all trust is at 51%. All right, you can hang out here. Let's go grab divinity. Oops, that's a wall. Hi, divinity. All right, let's come in and take care of you. How much she's got? Yeah, 11% potential. So I think I should be able to finish her training today. I don't know if she'll have enough energy to do competitions and training though. Say she is at 25. Oh, I do have some alfalfa. Good. There we go. Now I've got 100% satiety. I don't think I have any. No, I don't have any grain. Oh, I do have oats, but that's just Phil's satiety. So I don't really need that. Let's give you a brush. Oh, she is filthy. There you go. What else needs to be done with her care? Did I already clean out her stall? Oh, I didn't place straw down. That's what it is. Knew something was missing. Okay. Yeah, I guess we'll keep that gear on her. And oops, now let's mount. And let's go finish your training. I think I might do some training in here. We can do some jumping and some cantering around. I feel like that'll be the easiest way to get, we'll do wooden cavaletti. I think that'll be the easiest way to train her quickly is by doing some jumping and cantering around, because then we'll be working on multiple stats. Actually, what's her jump at? Is she intermediate yet? No, she isn't. She's not going to get to intermediate. That's okay, because I'm selling her anyway. But it would have been fun to get her to the intermediate jumping level. Alright, come on. One for speed. You can also get some flexibility training in there. Oops. That was a fail. Sorry, Divinity. I feel like the flower fence course might actually have more obstacles. I'm gonna go grab that one instead. Oh, her energy's going down quickly. Okay. Let's get the flower fence. Yeah, that has more obstacles, I'm pretty sure. Okay. Here we go. Get you trained. Whoops. So I think this will be a faster way to train than just galloping her around. Because it's multiple things at once, I think. That's my theory. Her energy's going down faster, so I guess that's a good indication. Okay, what's her potential at now? Oh, 6%! Okay, yes, this is fast. So I think we'll be able to get her fully trained, and then if I give her an apple, we should have enough energy to do at least one competition. Maybe two, but I think it'll only have to be one today. But that's okay. Okay, what's her potential at now? 4%. Just a little bit more. And we'll be able to sell her for a profit. I can't can't remember exactly how much I bought her for. I think it was just under 3,000. So as long as I sell her for over 3,000, I will have made a profit. Oh, her energy's going though. Maybe we won't be able to do a race today. I'll see. I'll take her energy all the way down and then I'll see. She might be able... I know she can do a race, but the point is I need her to be able to win a race. She might be able to win the town race, because that's an easy beginner race. How are we doing? 2%. Okay, just a little bit more divinity and then you will be fully trained. Hopefully we can get her fully trained before her energy runs out. I think this line is really good because it's just jumps after jumps and it's also training her speed at the same time. Alright. Okay, her energy is completely run out. 1%! Okay, I need to give her an apple. Oh, we're not going to be able to do a competition today. No! I was really hoping we would. Okay. Come on. Let's get you trained. Alright. She trained now? Yay! Okay, so what are her stats? She's 36% speed, 11% endurance, 20% jump, 22 flexibility, and no potential left. Alright, let's... I want to put her in the pasture, but I really need her to have full energy for combat. Actually, you know what? I don't. I think... No, I'll leave her in the stable tonight so that she'll have full energy for competitions tomorrow. And then we'll compete her in both of the competitions. And... get her feeling good. How much energy does Obsidian have left? Obsidian! Oh, I'm not... He doesn't trust me enough to come that far. Come on! There you go! Good boy! Okay. How much energy do you have? Oh, he has 10% energy. You know, we'll take you out, because I haven't taken you out much. Actually, you know, I want to change your attack, though, to something more comfortable, because we're not... Well, not more comfortable, but like something more, I don't know. Just something different because we're not doing competitions right now. Let me see how the black Western tack looks because I've gotten used to the black English tack. Yeah, I think I like this. I like the look of the brown tack on him. I don't quite know why, but I just think it looks nice. Yeah, okay. Let's go out Obsidian. It's kind of, I don't know, rustic. I'm going to take him out to the Lupine Meadow. Oh, we're not going to be able to gallop for very long. Because I want to get some more of the Lucky Fertilizer to put onto my crops. I'd take him and compete him in another race. Alright. You know, I feel like I should... maybe not. I was thinking maybe I should buy another course from River. Like another jumping course. But I'm quite happy with the courses I currently have. Is Jay home? He is not. Otherwise, I was going to go say hi to him. Okay. Let's go to the Lupine Meadow. And... need to make my way over to Aisha. Oh, known for her cheerful personality, she runs the fresh market, grows all kinds of plants in the Lupine Meadow. Okay, let's go. I was just thinking it'd be fun if we had like a quest or we had to herd the sheep in the Lupine Meadow into some sort of paddock or pen. I know that'd be fun because you can move the little sheep around. Oh my god, we just came off a cliff. We're fine. Oh, oats. Oh, the sun's going down and I know I'm supposed to go that way, but oats, I see them glowing. Oh, I see more oats over there. Okay, I'm only going to get this one lot of oats and I need to remember to sell them to George on my way home. Oh, and I have some manure I can sell to Aisha as well so that she can make her fertilizer with it. All right, come on, Obsidian. Just spending a nice afternoon out in the lupine meadow with my very first horse. He's such a good boy. See, how fun would it be to, like, have to herd the sheep? Oh, let's herd this sheep over towards Aisha. Come on. That would be a fun quest. Okay, I'll leave you alone now, sheep. Okay. Oh, and she's still here in the fields. Good. Okay, let's... stop the guide. There we go. Hi, Aisha. Oh, sorry, I'm kind of trampling your crops. Can you stay there? Hi! Well, well, look who's here. You can always buy seeds from my store, but if you're lucky, you might find some wild seeds while gathering forage. Looks like a perfect day to plant some new seeds. I want to buy... some... I already have enough wheat seeds, I think. Or do I have some... actually, do I have any Timothy hay seeds? Because that's another thing I'll need. I do. And I still have two wheat seeds. Okay, I think we should be okay. Actually, no, I'll buy like... oops, no quests. I'll buy one more wheat seed. And let's get some more of the lucky fertilizer, because that's fun. Let's get 5. Awesome, and now I just want to sell you some manure to make your fertilizer with. Oh, and some straw. You can use some straw to make your fertilizer too. Let's do 7. There you go. Okay, thank you, Aisha. Alright, let's go, Obsidian. And we'll ride back so that I can gather some more, some more crops on our way home. Like this orchard grass, and we can sell them to George. Come on. Okay, I don't see any more crops. It is starting to get late though. It's 6:10. So we should be heading back. Look at this cute little paddock. Okay, yeah, I don't see any more crops. I think this is the way home. Pretty sure this is the way home. It'll be embarrassing if this isn't the way home. Oh, I need to look out for treats too. Because how many apples do I have? I have 4 apples. I could use some more apples. Might sell some of my carrots to George. I wish I could grow some apple trees. That would be really handy. Okay, maybe this isn't the way home. You know what, we're just gonna teleport home. Just because it is getting late and I wanna still... Oh! This one's glowing too! Oh! A faint glow seems to envelop gold charm statue. Oh, so it's not just the one in town. It's both of them. Interesting. Okay. I'm actually kind of glad that he doesn't lose energy just from riding around that makes things much more handy. I would just have full energy the whole time and can gallop him around and get around pretty quickly. So that's nice. Okay, is George in his store? He's not. He's in the village marketplace. Okay. Let's go catch him and sell him some of my goods. I can hear the crickets. Hi, chickens. Oh, I want chickens on my farm so badly. Wouldn't they be adorable? Alright. This river. Oh, there's George. George, hi. Good day, Misty. Now, I'm sure you've noticed I only stock the essentials here in my store. A little bit of everything, in case you need it in a pinch. Of course, you'll sometimes want to purchase more specialized items. These can usually be found in town in the neighboring stores. Neighboring stores? We don't have any yet. But sometimes you'll have to venture out on the trails to find some of the most unique stores. Okay, no quests. I want to sell, was there anything I want to buy from him? Nah, I've got already got all, ooh, black western blanket. That could actually look really cool with the brown tag. Oh, but maybe not on obsidian. I don't know, let's buy it and just see what it looks like. Thank you. And, is there a difference between the black western bridle and, oh, never mind. I thought there was a black classic bridle. There isn't, because they're all just black bridles. Let's sell you all of my orchard grass. And all of my oats, I think. And we'll sell you 5 carrots. I think that's good. Okay. Thank you, George. Oh, and River's here. Let's talk to her. Hi, Misty. One thing you have to keep in mind is that horses can get tired out pretty easily. So if you're planning on entering a competition, it's always best to make sure your horse has as much energy as possible. Trust me, it'll definitely improve your chances. If your horse is feeling a little drained after a while, no worries. You can always switch to a different horse for the day and give your competition horse a chance to rest. They deserve it. Let's do our best today. Okay, bye. Oh wait, how much is another course? Oh, I could get intermediate cavalier or beginner barrel course. You know, let's get it just to see what it looks like compared to the other ones. I'll try it out next time. I guess. Or I guess I can have a look at it when I get home. We can just teleport back to the beginning. There we go. Oh, there's some straw. I'll grab this since I sold a bunch of my straw. Okay. Alright. Come on, Obsidian. Let's go have a quick look at what this barrel course looks like. It's only the beginner one. Maybe I should have gotten some intermediate stuff, but I don't know, I kind of like training out on the trails more. But if I'm doing, like, if I have a project horse, it can be nice to do, like, some quick training in the arena. I think training in the arena, it's not as fun, but it's definitely faster. Training on the trails is more fun, but it's slower. Okay, how does the country barrel course look? Ooh, oh, this is nice, so it actually goes in a circle. Oh, I like this. And then I could go around this one. Oops. Or I could just do like the outside jumps because they kind of go in a circle. Oh, I'm failing. They kind of go in like a nice little course. I like this. I like when the jumps are set out like really easily. I think this would be kind of good for flexibility too because there's plenty of little turns and things. I like this course. I'm glad I got this. It's only the beginner level, but I'm glad I got it. I think this will be useful for training project horses because it just goes in a nice, neat little circle with an extra jump at the end. Okay. Oh, and I need to fertilize my crops before I go to bed. All right, obsidian. Let's give you a quick brush. You go. And we'll put you back out in the pasture. And divinity, you're all set. Okay. Is there anything else? Oh yeah, I've already checked out the new course. I just need to put some lucky fertilizer on my crops and then I'll be off to bed. Is there any straw over here? No. All right. Oh, and I need to, oh wait, I already planted these. Okay, let's fertilize my Timothy. That's here. Okay, and what's this one? 4 days, 2 days. Fertilize this one. I wanna fertilize the ones that are gonna be ready the soonest. 7 days. 4 days. Did this one get fertilized? I'm not sure if it did. It doesn't look like it did. Huh. I guess it's glitched, this one. I don't know if it's actually gotten fertilized or not. Let's fertilize this, though. I guess we'll just fertilize everything. There we go. That one's been fertilized. We'll fertilize this one. And that one seems to be glitched, too. Unless it's already been fertilized, and that's why it's not letting me do it. Is that why? I know I fertilized this one. Will it let me fertilize it twice? It will. Okay, so that's weird. Some of my crops seem to be glitching and not fertilizing. Weird. I'm not sure if they actually are, or if... Because I feel like I've fertilized some stuff before and it did fertilize, but it didn't remove a fertilizer. I guess that's just a bug. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and end this episode here. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, as well as subscribe and hit the notification bell. That way you'll be notified every time I upload a video. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye!